Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to be doing a little bit more work on our Mercury Verado 200. Today we're going to be using part of a kit that will actually replace the seals and the O-ring on the shift shaft, more specifically the housing of the shift shaft. Now I already bought a kit that comprises most of the seals and O-rings that are needed to reseal the entire lower unit. Today we're just going to focus on the shift shaft. But let me show you that parts kit I'm talking about. With this one part number from Mercury, you actually have all the seals and gaskets and O-rings associated with this lower unit. To do the whole thing, it addresses your input shaft seal as well as your output shaft seals and O-rings. Then it also deals with the shift shaft, and that's what we're going to deal with today. Now, if you need help doing those other sections, why don't you reference the playlist for this particular unit and I can walk you through that. Well, we've got our three pieces out of this kit that we're going to need for today, so let's hop over there and get this taken care of. Now we've already installed the input shaft seals as well as the housing. We've already done a water pump on this one as well. Now we're going to go ahead and do the shift shaft. And guess what? After we finish it, then we're going to dive down and take care of that output shaft. Now this is really going to be easy. Basically there are just four bolts that I have to remove. Now once we lift off the housing, we're going to find an O-ring down inside the casing, as well as a seal that we're going to push out of the housing and replace. Now, if you've done a pressure test on your unit and it is losing air, or pressure rather, chances are if you've located one area, the other areas that have the same seals that are almost as old or older, it's going to leak as well. So it is a smart move if you go through the pain to drop this unit out just to do all of it. I mean, why not? Because the hardest part is actually removing the unit and then reinstalling it. As I was talking about earlier, all you have here is just an O-ring, which is actually right here. When we go to install the new one, it'll go on this end and then go into it. Then you have a gasket. There's a rubber washer on this side. And here's that other seal I was talking about. So what we're going to do is take this over to the parts washer, get it cleaned up, get this pulled out, get it greased back up, get the new seals and the gaskets and O-rings, and then just put it back together. It's going to be that simple. We've got our gasket peeled off. Next, let's reach in, grab that seal, see if we can wiggle it out. When you're doing this, do not gouge the outer edge, because if you gouge this as you're coming up, guess what? That's where it's going to leak. With that removed, I'm going to take it over, get it cleaned up, then we're going to put the new pieces back in. We've got her cleaned up reasonably well, so let's go ahead and get our seal back in. I'm using just a 13 millimeter socket to sink it all the way down. That should be it. Now we're going to take a little bit of grease and just work it around the inside of that seal. That should do. Now we're going to go ahead and install our O-ring on this side and put just a light coat of grease on it to where it's easier to get it back in the housing. All right, that's ready to go. I've got our rubber washer cleaned up. We'll wait to put it on until we actually get the shaft to come through, put a little bit more grease, and then we'll push this down on it. Grab our new gasket. Let's push this housing down. Little bit more grease, our rubber washer. Now let's get our bolts back in. Make sure the gasket's lined up properly so you don't damage it. All right guys, that wraps up this part of the project. What are we going to do next? We're actually going to dive down and take care of that output shaft seal. Now if you would like to see that happen, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button, that way you'll be notified when we complete that video and post it. Plus, it'll tell you whatever I'm working on next. Now listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.